Well, before I go, I'd like to tell you a story of something that happened to me once years ago on a reading tour in Tallahassee in Florida. Near Tallahassee, about 15 miles outside town, there's a little place called Wakulla Springs. And at Wakulla Springs, about 200 feet below the surface of the earth, from a cave, there rises a crystal clear river, quite a large river. It's a very mysterious river. The caves under the ground, they found dinosaur bones, and they can't trace the river. It comes from hundreds of miles away, but they can't trace the mountains it comes from or anything. And on the banks of this river, there's an extraordinary animal life and bird life, and in the waters of the river, there's an extraordinary fish life. Well, I was staying at the little hotel there, and I was walking by the side of the river, and I saw a little notice board. And on this notice board was crudely written, "Take a trip in the glass bottom boat and see Henry the Jumping Bass." Well, I was curious. So I went a trip in the glass bottom boat, and the trip was conducted by an old colored gentleman. And sure enough, there was a little vaulting bar at the bottom of the river, which you could see on account of the very clear water. And the old colored gentleman said, "Come along, Henry, come along." And a fish came along. And then he said, "Jump, Henry, jump." And the fish jumped over the bar. Then he called some catfish up from the deep. He said, "Come up, catfish, come up, catfish." Hundreds of catfish came up from the deep, and they formed in military formation, and they marched underneath the boat. Then he turned his head very suddenly, and he said, "Jump, Big Joey, jump." And a 14-foot alligator jumped up in the water and made a big splash. Well, I'd never seen an alligator before. The effect was pretty startling. Well, I went back to the hotel, and I was filled with awe. This old gentleman was in touch with nature. He could command the fishes of the river. And I thought of the words in the first chapter of Genesis, "And let them have dominion over the fish of the sea and over the fowl of the air and over the cattle and over every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth." But there was something else. I felt some kind of kinship with that old gentleman, and I didn't know what it was. So I went out on the boat again and again and again. And I watched him, and he became very uneasy because I was watching him. Well, I learned that his name was Chester, and he had an Uncle Ed. And his Uncle Ed had found out there's a certain kind of bass which swims in the waters of Wakulla Springs. It has an irritating algae on its stomach. It has the habit of jumping over the sharp edges of rocks to scrape off the irritating algae. So this cunning old Uncle Ed had built a stone vaulting bar at the bottom of the river with a very sharp edge. And of course, from lifelong observation of the movements of the fish, he knew exactly when it was about to jump. And at that moment, he said, "Jump, Henry, jump." And it looked as if the fish was obeying his command. And then when he had our attention directed elsewhere, he surreptitiously dropped some crumbs over the stern of the boat. And of course, the catfish came up to get the crumbs. They all headed into the current of the river, as fish do, all parallel. And he moved the glass-bottom boat slowly over the shoal of fish. And it looked for all the world as if they were marching in military formation. And to heighten the illusion, he hummed Schubert's Marche Militaire. Wade got that idea, famous idea. And then, while we were watching the catfish, he'd be pointing this way, he'd pick up a rock from the back of him, and he heaved it backhanded at where he knew the alligator was lying at the edge of the river. The alligator jumped on account of it, he'd been hit by the rock. And just before that moment, he turned his head and said, "Jump, Big Joey, jump." And it looked as if the great reptile was obeying his spoken command. Well, I came off the trip this time, and there's a little wooden hut at the side of the river. It's still there. And he was waiting for me in the shadow of that with his great big eyes open and looking at me. He was really scared. I think he thought I'd found out the tricks of his trade, or he might have thought I was the FBI, I don't know. Anyway, he said to me, "Who are you, mister?" And I looked him straight in the eye, and I said, "I'm a storyteller too." And he said, "What kind of stories do you tell, mister?" "Well," I said, "I tell the stories in the Bible and in Shakespeare." He said, "Good enough. You come for a free ride in my boat anytime you want to." So I'd made a friend. And I've shown you all the tricks of my trade. So good night.